Hey everyone, Cliff Snedeker here, your Build It Better series host. Have you ever wondered what goes into the testing of a product for seismic, Class A, or total acoustics performance? On this episode, we will cover the seismic testing portion on the shake table in Buffalo, New York. You will witness firsthand how we are setting the standard with the largest portfolio of tested ceiling systems in the industry, which allows you to design and install with confidence. I will showcase the testing in progress and the rigor our team of experts goes through when installing and shake testing as many as 15 400 square foot installations in just 1 week. Ready to get started? Let's get shaking. Hey, I'm up here. It's January up in Buffalo, and I have Paul Huff here. Paul, what do you do? What's your function here at the seismic testing?
I'm basically the coordinator of the testing, set the testing up. We arrange all the different systems, do the reports, plan all the materials. Basically, that's it. Run the show.
Run the show. Yeah, I see we got an army of people back here. Installing some ceilings for our next shake test. What's the size of this table?
The table itself is actually not that large. It's only about a 6x6 or an 8x8. What you're looking at though, and what you see on top of it is there's a transition frame that then takes that out to a workspace that's about 25 feet by 25 feet. On top of that then, we've constructed a frame. Our frame is basically to mimic the walls of a building. And that frame is 20 feet by 20 feet. So it gives us an overall plan of 400 square feet.
So we're doing 400 square feet.
400 square feet of ceiling at a time.
How many are you doing a week?
We typically do anywhere from 8 to probably 14, 15.
14 different builds.
Depends on how many we can fit in, how complicated the builds are, and how much detail we have to get in, how much problems we have.
And then we shake it and we analyze it.
We shake it, we break it, we analyze it, we tear it down, and we start all over.
So if we were to lift up the hood of this shake table, we'd see a 6x6
We see a small assembly, table,
And it comes up.
On underneath that table, then there's a number of actuators.
Okay.
And some of those actuators, well, they're very, very large actuators, basically hydraulic driven. So they will give you motion, and we have motion, I think, in 6 different directions.
Really?
So we can go side to side, up and down. We can do yaws and rolls and all kind of things all at the same time.
So this really, at best, I mean, this more most perfectly, it resembles a real earthquake because you don't know which way.
You don't know what's coming. That's all driven because all those hydraulics are then tied to the computer system and the control room. And that basically simulates kind of an overall earthquake. And it gives you a lot of random motions and a lot of unpredictable things.
Wow. Really interesting.
Yep.
Now, does Armstrong, do this testing for all their, how do we decide what products we test?
We basically go through and we look at products that we have, that we might have a concern with. If we're not sure of the performance, or it's something that does not meet the prescriptive building code, we typically want to take a look at it to make sure that we limit our liability, and we want to make sure that it's safe for our customers and their customers to use.
Hey, I'm up here with John Dose. This is the table boss. How's it going, man?
How's it going?
This guy runs everything up on the inner sanctum here. This is a big 400 square foot table. What are we installing, John?
Well, today we're doing some wood ceiling. So we got a heavy duty grid install, mains 2 foot on center. Some unique perimeter conditions because we have some custom wood ceiling that we're testing.
So what do we do before every test? Is...
Well, we got our grid drawing, our panel drawing. Every test has its own unique set of drawings, and we're up here with all of our installation specialists.
How long does it take to do an installation like this?
Well, you know, it just really depends on each build. Each build is unique. we've got so much testing behind us now. The standard testings are you know, we're well ahead of the curve on standard testing. So like, this is a unique custom job, and we're testing it.
Yeah.
No, so it can be you know, it can be installed in California.
Great.
Seismic zones.
Looking forward to the test.
So, yep.
Let's get it shaking.
Okay. All right.
So hey, these weeks that we spend up here in Buffalo, you know, we're doing 10 to 15 tests, and a lot of stuff has to be done prior to us getting up and installing it on the shake table. There's got to be a lot of prep work done to allow us to install it quickly and efficiently. So I got Dave Maurer here. He's our floor boss, and he whips everybody into shape, our crew down on the floor that prepares everything and gets it ready for a quick installation so then we can move on to the next. So tell me what you do here, Dave.
Well, what we do here, we, like Cliff had said, we run 10 to 15 tests per week. So there's a lot of material that sits around here. What I do is I try to keep it organized, nice and safe, clean atmosphere around here. What the crew's doing in the background now is they're preparing for a test that's going to be later installed later today. We try to be one step ahead of the installers that are on the table.
Yeah, what are you preparing with here now?
This is a downlining project for the planks.
Okay. Yeah, the integrated downlining.
Integrated downlining project for the planks. Cutting the lengths to fit the table.
How's all this material get up here?
Material is gathered 2 weeks prior to arriving here it arrives in Lancaster, and then I take it from Lancaster by truck up to here so we make sure the material is all ready here to go when we're ready to run the test.
So rain, snow, sun, shine, whatever.
Yep.
Dave's
yep.
driving it up
yep.
here.
Yep, we're driving it up here in the heat of the summer and the cold of the winter.
Yep, that's great. That's great. Hey, what we got going on right now, it's a custom wood ceiling, and it's a slightly different build than what we've done in the past. So we want to seismically test it, make sure we're up to code and everything's working great. But real exciting. Can't wait to see this one shook.
It's at 2.25 now. This thing's really shaking.
This was a pretty cool test here. I guess this one's confirmed. We tested our 1-inch transition steel transition molding, which transitions 1 inch from a drywall ceiling to an acoustical ceiling like you have right here. We took this to 3.0, which is the maximum this table will do and is far exceeds what we would see in any earthly earthquake. So, myth busted, we don't need uplift struts at the 1-inch transition point between acoustical and drywall.
Okay, we're here in the middle of a seismic evaluation. What you're gonna be looking at on the shake table is really a series of simulated earthquakes. Each one is designed so that it goes through about a 5-second build. We hold a strong motion for about 20 seconds, and then there's a decay for about 5 seconds. So each shake is about 30 seconds total. Those shakes are basically designed. They come from what we call a design spectral response, and that comes directly from some of the geological survey maps. We can pick it off. That's a acceleration, ground motion acceleration in percent G. We've then taken that and we've taken a base level and we scale that up or down. So we start with the one that we just watched was a 0.25. So that's 25% of the base level of 100. We then scale it up to 0.5, 0.75, 1.0. And then we continue to scale up and we can go to a maximum of 3.0 G. Each time you go up, it gets progressively stronger, more acceleration, more violence. And it can be very telling. What we're looking at, the ceiling.
0.5.
Excuse me? Okay. We're looking at the ceiling and we're trying to assess a couple limit states, or if you want to call it damage areas. One damage area is we're looking at grid to make sure that the grid is not damaged where it needs to be replaced or repaired. And the other one is we typically do not want ceiling panels coming out, falling to the floor, hitting the floor of the table. Either one of those would be a failure, and we would drop down to the level of shaking below where that occurred, and that's where we would consider our passing, if you want to call it that, level. What we're doing is we're looking at the ceiling surface and also all grid connections. We're looking for movement of panels. We're looking for movement of grid. You're listening for unusual noises or sounds. And typically, when there's something that's a little bit different, it stands out and it piques our interest, and we start to go in and look very, very closely. You could really tell by sitting back just watching, in most cases, exactly where your damage is starting to occur, and you can assess the level of performance of the ceiling system.
I'm Jason Amin, the Technical Services Manager of Armstrong Ceiling Grid. At this point, we're just about to hit 1.75G. This is the threshold of the level, the minimum level of acceptance that we shoot for. The nice thing about this testing is that we get to measure our theoretical ceiling performance versus an actual. With the different types of ceilings that we're manufacturing and installing now, they're a lot more complicated, and it's not just a lightweight ceiling panel in a lay-in grid. So there's so many more member interactions that it's becoming increasingly difficult to calculate or model. So to be able to do a test such as this, we really get a chance to not only make better designs, but recommendations to our designers on the front end. And there we go. We hit the minimum we were shooting for, and now it's just time to have fun and see how far it goes.
Well, are you dizzy from all that shaking? Hopefully you got a good impression on the lengths that Armstrong Ceiling and Wall Solutions goes through to ensure the highest levels of performance, comfort, and safety. To learn more, visit armstrongceilings.com/seismic. Thanks for watching this episode of Build It Better. Tune in next month to see what project I land on next. To view past episodes, visit armstrongceilings.com/BIB.